Welcome everyone. In the previous videos, we have studied how the noise can limit the minimum signal which can be used for the RF and microwave circuits. Now we are going to discuss another important parameter which also limits the minimum and the maximum value of the input signals and the output signals and at the RF and microwave circuits. This other parameter is the nonlinear distortion. It is assumed that the RF circuit and microwave circuit in its operating range is mainly having a linear performance. The question now, at very low limit of input signal or at very high limit of input signal, both low limit and high limit, this linear relation is not valid ideally. So we say that ideal linear component does not exist in the practice because all realistic devices are nonlinear at very low signal and also at very high signal. At very low signal, they are linear due to the noise effect, and at high signals, they are nonlinear because of the saturation. So, in addition, practical components may also become nonlinear at high signals. As an example, in the case of active devices such as diodes or transistors, this may be due to the effect such as gain compression or generation of suppression or generation of suppressed frequency component due to the device nonlinearity. But in general, generally speaking, all devices in general fail at very high power level. So at very high power level, the performance of any device will be completely different from the linear portion. This effect due to the nonlinearity will introduce the minimum and the maximum realistic power range. And the minimum and maximum realistic power range for any device or any circuit, this corresponds to what we are calling the dynamic range of this system or this circuit. So this effect sets a minimum and maximum realistic power range or dynamic range over which a given component or circuit will operate at the required operation. Devices like diodes and transistors have nonlinear characteristics, and sometimes this nonlinearity has some advantages or some usage. For example, in the case of detection or frequency conversion, we use these nonlinear properties of active devices like the diodes and transistors to introduce active circuits like microwave detector or microwave mixer and so on. So the nonlinearity is not a complete disadvantage. We can use this nonlinearity to introduce other options or other applications from the microwave circuits. On the other hand, nonlinear device characteristics, however, can also lead to undesirable effects such as gain compression, generation of spurious frequency components. These effects may lead to increased losses and signal distortion, and also it may introduce some interference between the input signal. Assume that I have two input signals. For example, in a communication system, if I have two input signals from two different users, the nonlinearity may introduce some interference between the signals of the two signals. And this is what we are calling a crosstalk in the microwave circuits. So, nonlinearity is in general a very important characteristic for RF and microwave circuits. For circuits which depend on the linear properties, nonlinearity will present a disadvantage. On the other hand, for RF circuits based on the nonlinear properties like microwave detectors, microwave mixers, the nonlinearity is a very important characteristic and it should be used in the appropriate way to obtain the required performance. The general effects of nonlinearity can be summarized into these points. The first point is harmonic generation. Assume that I have an input signal with frequency f naught, and the device is nonlinear device or the circuit is nonlinear circuit. So the output, it will include a component with a frequency f naught and other components with 2f naught, 3f naught, 4f naught, and so on. So we have some harmonic generation due to the nonlinearity. If I'm talking about an amplifier, for example, this would be a disadvantage. But if I'm talking about a frequency multiplier, this would be a great advantage. And in the case of a frequency multiplier, for example, if I'm interested in generation of millimeter wave signal, assume that I'm interested in generation, for example, 120 gigahertz. I'm using a source with 40 gigahertz and I'm using a frequency multiplier which is based on harmonic generation to generate the third harmonic. So from the 40 gigahertz I can generate the 120 gigahertz. Most millimeter wave sources are based on microwave sources followed by a frequency multiplier. So the effect of nonlinearity for harmonic generation is a disadvantage in the case of an amplifier, but it is the required parameter for the case of a circuit like a frequency multiplier. Another effect for nonlinearity is the saturation. Saturation is basically in the case for the amplifier. In the case of an amplifier, as I'm increasing the input power, the output power will be increased. Until I reach certain level, if I'm increasing the input power, the output power will not increase anymore. So in this case, we say that we have reached to saturation. And effectively, in this case, I have lost the amplification factor of the amplifier. Intermodulation distortion. Intermodulation distortion and cross modulation, effectively, they are talking about if I have two signals and the system is nonlinear in somehow, then the output of the signal will include the original or the frequencies of the original signals in addition to the frequency of the intermodulation between the two signals. Effectively, this is the basic idea of microwave mixer. But if I'm talking about an amplifier, the intermodulation and cross modulation will be disadvantage. So according to the required microwave device, maybe the effect of the nonlinearity would be a disadvantage or it would be an advantage or the desired property. Another effect is amplitude modulation to phase modulation conversion. In amplitude modulation to phase modulation conversion, if I have a signal with different amplitudes, due to the saturation, I can obtain that the output signal will have some frequency component or some different frequency component. So, the output frequency or the output phase shift will depend on the input amplitude. This is what's called amplitude modulation to phase modulation conversion. If I'm talking about an amplifier, this would be a completely disadvantage. But if I'm talking about phase modulator, for example, this would be the required product of the system. Spectral regrowth, effectively, due to the intermodulation, cross-modulation, and amplitude to phase modulation, conversion, and so on, all these properties will introduce that the spectrum of the input signal could be less than the spectrum of the output signal. So, effectively, the spectrum of the output signal will be increased in somehow. And this is completely disadvantaged if I'm talking about something like frequency division and multiplexing. In this case, if I have an input signal with a certain bandwidth, the output of the microwave circuit or the microwave system will have a bandwidth greater than the input signal. This means that there will be some interference between the closed channels. This vector regrowth or intermodulation will close this based signals. These are the main effects of the nonlinearity, and as I said, these effects can be a disadvantage for the devices which are designed to be working in the linear region, and it could be an advantage for the devices which are based on the nonlinear properties. The general representation for any nonlinear network, assuming that we are talking about the input voltage and the output voltage, we can say that the output voltage equals a constant value equals A naught plus a constant value A1 multiplied by the input signal V input plus another constant A2 multiplied by the square value of the input signal plus a third constant or a fourth constant A3 multiplied by the cubic value of the signal and so on. Effectively, we have presented here as a function of the input voltage and the output voltage. Generally, it can be represented as the input current or and output current, the input electric field and output electric field, the input magnetic field and the output magnetic field. But in general, we say that the output signal is related to the input signal as a Taylor series. The first component represents the DC output of the network, which has a constant value. The second component will represent the linear property of this microwave circuit or this microwave system. And this corresponds to the linear output. And the magnitude A1 here equals the derivative of the output voltage to the input voltage, and the input voltage equals zero. In a similar way, the second component represent, or the third component, sorry, the third component represent to the squared output. Here, the signal is proportional to the square value of the input signal, and so on. We say that the constant term A0 with coefficient A0 leads to the rectification. So, if I have AC signal or RF signal here, the rectified signal will correspond to the first term A0, which is converting the AC component to a DC signal. The second term is the linear term with the coefficient A1. A1 here, if it is greater than unity, it represents the amplification. If it is less than unity, it represents to the attenuation. So, according to the device, if it is amplifying the signal, could be the amplification coefficient A1, or if it is attenuating the signal, it would be the attenuation coefficient, it would be A1. So the linear term with the coefficient A1 models the linear attenuation, assuming that A1 is less than unity, or the linear amplification, assuming that A1 is greater than unity. The second term represents, with the coefficient A2, represents the squared value. And this squared value is basically used for frequency mixing. And almost all microwave mixers depend on this term. The second order term is the core term for microwave mixer. So can be used for mixing and other frequency conversion functions. The cubic term can be represented or can be used for generation, the third harmonic of the signal, and so on. Practical nonlinear devices usually have a series expansion containing many non-zero terms and combination of several of all of other of all above effect. So effectively, for the general nonlinear device, we have some rectification, we have linear amplification, we have mixing application amplification, we have a third or harmonic generation, and so on. So for the general nonlinear device, all these effects are mixed inside the nonlinear device. But for a specific device, some term it would be the dominant term, and this dominant term it would be the main application for this nonlinear device. Now we have represented the general representation for nonlinear device or network. In the following video, we are going to talk about the gain compression and how, for example, an amplifier, the gain will be constant for a certain region, and then this gain it will be going to saturation, such that the output signal will not be increasing anymore as the input signal increases, and this is called the gain compression. And we will see how to define this gain compression and what is the effect of this gain compression. This is what we are going to discuss in the following video. Alright, see you in the next video.